All right, welcome back to the channel. Let's go ahead and knock out video 4 of 4 tonight. We just got done with the antique store finds, also with cheap card sales, and with At Eric's Fire stack sales. So lastly, we're gonna be doing the largest of the four. I guess I'll just grab a little bit at a time and kind of do it in halvesies here. And we'll do eBay last, and we'll call it a night. And really appreciate you guys for sticking around and watching all of them. Even though probably some of this collection is not probably your forte or whatever. Just because, you know, everybody's tastes are different. People like different players, teams, and whatnot. And a lot of my stuff isn't high of a dollar value. It's because I love it, and I love collecting it, and, you know, it's just my little niche of the world for collections. All right, so the first part of this is going to be a lot of Jeff Manto, and everyone's going to be like, what, who? Jeff is actually, was born in Bristol, Pennsylvania. That is where I was born and raised. It's where my parents were born and raised. And backstory is, Jeff actually married my dad's cousin, Donna. He's related by marriage, and I've met him a couple times, and I have a couple signed baseball cards for him, and I just, you know, it's fun to collect family, I guess, you know, so it's something I still do, and rightfully so. He's a pretty good ball player. A lot of it was just timing, and he never really got a full-time gig until at Baltimore. He really started to play. It was the year Ripken surpassed Lou Gehrig's Iron Horse record, and he was playing a lot of first and third and DH and stuff. I think he hit like 16 bombs that year, and 40, 50 RBI, something like that. I'll probably find it on here, but he was a journeyman and a utility guy and stuff. And I mean, you guys can go on Baseball Reference and look at all of it. A lot of stuff. A lot of these cards I did have. I'll go through the ones that I really didn't. I never really saw this one. It was always on the back of the stadium clubs, which I have some in here. And I'll show you. I'm calling this his rookie card. Because this is from the, I thought it was from the traded set. This almost looks like a Tiffany on the back, but I don't think it is. But it was nice to have that. It's a Pacific League. Or Pacific's baseball card when he was actually on the Phillies. And he was on the Phillies, Braves, came up with the Angels, broke through with the Indians. I think he was Rockies, Baltimore, like I said. Had a stint on Boston and also with my Yankees. So I love seeing the minor league cards. When he was on the Colorado Springs Sky Sox. One of these, where is it, Quad City, Midland? I think this is the year Midland. In 88, he actually won International Minor League Player of the Year. Like you see, like 300 hitter, 100 RBIs in 120 games. If he played in this generation of baseball, you know, he'd be a 240, 250, 30 bombs, 90 ribbies, you know. Not much of a walker, but, you know, 30 doubles, 30 bombs, 90 ribs, you know, 240, 250 batting average. It's a nice top finest when he's with Baltimore. I wonder if they have the season on here. Was it 95? Now, I can't remember what year he, yes, even here, 281, you know, 12 and 30. In limited time, 146 at-bats. I mean, I think there was something there. And it's just opportunity. And I believe it. I think these are 91s. Yeah, 1991. But one's the base, which I have in a set, and I also have a couple more of these, but I saw it was cheap on eBay, so I got it. But this is the Tiffany, which I did not have. I did not have a Tiffany. Manto. But if you know coming up through the Angels and Indians, probably behind like Jim Thome at this time. I forget who the third baseman was. Thome, like people like Carlos Baerga, like he's behind when he's at the Braves, he's behind Klesko and Chipper Jones. Like there was also like roster, you know, things going on that it just he couldn't break through. I always love this card. It's probably one of my favorite cards. The Score 91 rookie prospect. And then a couple of Fleers when he was playing with Angels. Never played with the Angels themselves, but yeah, this is the updated 89 update Fleer. But he was in their farm system for a long time. So 1991 upper deck. And maybe he was a little bit more of a walker than I thought. He walked more than he struck out. So 224 average. I bet you if you look back at some of the Stratcast stuff, he's probably a lot of it. His batting average probably his expected batting average value is probably a lot higher. Probably in the 250s or something. His BABIP probably is probably pretty high. So another Fleer. And then is there a couple of Score in here? Oh, there's a Score. There's a couple cards in here. There's a 92. This video is running long already, but it's all right. So there's 92 behind it. There's another Bowman. And then the Donruss 91. There. I forgot there's like three cards in it. And of course, I mean, you find those cheap for like less than a dollar free shipping. This one was very, very awesome. I actually had to get this off of Comp C. But this is a Mexican, I want to say Mexican League, or is it a Dominican League? I totally forget which one it is now. Man, I can't remember. So you're gonna have to look that up and everything. I just thought it was cool. It's in Spanish. I've never seen it before. I think I only paid $2 for the card, but it cost me like $4.95 for shipping. But definitely wanted to have it. BYN cards. One of those 90 Fleer updates, I want to say. Yeah. And then here's the stadium clubs I was talking about. Yeah, with the debut Topps card on the back, calling it his rookie card. And there's two of those. I don't know why I ordered two. Maybe it was a mistake. And it was, this one I didn't have either. It's pro cards at Colorado Springs Sky Sox. So yeah, but he had a lot of power. Yeah, quite a bit of power. And then next on the list here is, I already have another version of this too. I forget which number it is. But it's the Leaf Trinity Edition. Mike Pappy, 2014 Leaf. Auto, Cleveland Indians patch. Pappy actually graduated the same high school I did. Fell into the, went to Virginia for college, but then got drafted by the Cleveland Indians. First round, I think, 38th pick, something like that. And this was a cool, nice little pure Leaf Trinity 2014 autograph. I didn't have one of these yet. So you see the cool very image off that there. And there's a couple of these versions of these. One's green, orange, and they're, you know, priced differently for each one, but at least wanted to have one for my Pappy collection. And then coming up next is, I didn't have any of these growing up as a kid, and I was happy I found some Yankees cheap, because normally these go for like $4.80 a pop, but these, this Carl Everett, I didn't have any of these Desert Shield cards growing up, and these are my first ones obtaining. Each of these were like 99 cents with, I think it was like 99 cent shipping or dollar shipping or whatever. But I got Carl Everett draft pick, and I got Kevin Moss, and we just a bunch of Yankees. I know people are trying to like complete full sets of this, but I just wanted to have a few for my collection, add it to the Yankees binder. My Rick Cerrone, back when they had the Rizzuto Memorial patches, and then Bam Bam Mullins. So I was very happy to get those on the cheap. Nobody else was bidding on them. By now everybody knows my obsession with this card. And honestly, I wish I can get a giant one to hang on the wall. I just think it's one of the best baseball images ever. Just the sign of the times. You know, people going to the games in suits and fedoras and, you know, plus my infatuation with wall climbers images for baseball cards. So I think this is my fourth or fifth Jim Rivera I have. In pretty decent shape too, so excited to have that. I saw this, I forget where, I think someone posted it in on Twitter. Most of the time I see these things, I see them on Twitter and I go right to eBay, try to scour to see if I can get one. But I'm like, I grew up a weather nerd, you know, I've always into weather. Did combat weather for the Air Force for over a decade. I'm like, why do I not have a weather focused binder? Like, there are plenty of inserts and cards that have weather type graphics on them, or even team names that have weather names associated with them. So this is the start of my weather binder, I guess you can say. So Manny Ramirez, Fleer 95, the little tornado action going on there. So that was the start of it. And then I remembered, oh, hey, I have these as well. Canseco, I have one, it's in a binder with my Canseco PC, but I'm like, well, I might as well just get another one and put it in the weather binder. I always thought it was a very cool card. I actually like this one more than I like my Mattingly one. Power and speed. And then since I didn't get one in any of my blaster boxes, I went ahead and got one for like $1.50 for free shipping. I wanted to judge flashiest feet from series one. Never pulled it out of any of my blasters, so I just had to go to eBay to get it. So I'm glad to have that. That's probably one of my favorite Mets cards that I own. I just picked this up recently. It's the 85 Gooden. It's the variation. It's what there's on the back of the box. And player card one. This is hand cut off the back of the box. So, and it's cut pretty decent. You can see it's only a little bit off there. You can see a little bit of the cardboard. It's away from the yellow. But yeah, I think it's such a cool image of him up on the deck there. You see, you know, from right center to right field, tossing a ball up in the air. This sweet uniforms and the chain hanging. So very happy to have that. Schmitty, I don't know why I bought this. It wasn't $8. It definitely wasn't $8. It was, and I think it was like $1.25, if that. But I think this is 79. All right, yeah. This is one of the few sets that I don't have complete, which I'm kind of upset about because it's pricey and it's my birth year. So I get my kids their birth year sets sealed. So, you know, they have theirs, and I don't have a 79 set. I think the first set I do have is I'm missing 81 and 79. I have 80. And I have 82. I just bindered 82. But yeah, I don't have a full set of 79. And Schmitty was out there. Cheap. Looked like a good card. Good condition. So, I mean, just look at those numbers. Ugh. Crazy. So much power. So, yeah, I was happy to have that. All right, so a couple offbeat ones real quick till we get into some football. Just been doing a little bit of wrestling, collecting as well. Charlotte Flair and into rocking. Cena, like my main PC, so picked up a John Cena Heritage. I just think it's really cool with the profile photo and then an action shot next to it. So look at those real quick. And then the new Prisms came out. They've pretty much fallen off the face of the earth because I picked this up for 99 cents. And at one time I thought like people were, I saw like solds for like $10-$12. And I'm like, it's just a common. So I don't know what the rave was or the rush was with everything, but there's that. And then getting some football, Rick Meyer, Notre Dame, Seahawks. I got it mostly for the Notre Dame thing, but I'm thinking because of all the water and stuff, it might be added to the weather binder. It looks more weatherish or whatever. You have the clouds and the water, so I might add that to the weather binder instead of the Notre Dame football binder. But awesome card. And I have another one too. This one's getting put to the weather binder as well. Golden Gate Bridge, Ricky Waters, of course. Ricky Cool Running Waters. It was awesome with the lightning in the back, boat, rain showers. Awesome. Just kind of like the epitome of what you would see in a weather binder, I guess. I don't know. And then I saw this one too. I think Dub Mentality showed this one off on his timeline. I'm like, yeah, it looks like lightning to me. So add this one to the weather binder, Carolina Thunder. And then lastly, my third favorite player of all time is Eddie Jones, behind Barkley and Diana Taurasi. So I have a quite extensive Eddie Jones PC. So I just found a Bowman's Best. And if you go back to and look, and this is where my obsession with the three-quarter court photos started taking off. Eddie Jones has some of the most majestic photos in his cards. I challenge you to go back and look at some of Eddie Jones' base cards, especially on Upper Deck and stuff. They have a lot of him in very awesome poses, going up for dunks and whatnot. Is there anything on the back of this one? No, it's just a... But, I think I showed my all-time favorite basketball card, Eddie Jones card, of him, where Allen Iverson's on the back of it. It's just an incredible dunk photo. This is much of the same. This is a gorgeous shot. Same here against the Cavs, going up almost the baseline there. And what is that, Nick Van Exel on the back too? Nick at Night, number 9. Is that what I'm seeing? I love seeing, it's the other thing too. That's why I don't like Mosaic. Like I collect them and stuff. Things like Illusion and stuff. These are kind of cool because they have the other image photo variation. But like things like this, all right, you get away with it. See if I can find it. The mosaics I bought real quick, like this. I know I have some Tyrese Maxey. Oh, Paul Reed. This does not excite me. Your geometry, your graphics on the back is not. It doesn't really do it for me. I guess there's a. What's in the background now? I guess there's a little bit, but you really can't tell. All of this kind of takes up for it. I want to see, I want to see the crowd. I want to see, the game action going on. And these are brilliant. Look at this. You're just looking into a full arena. You can see all the way down at the other clock, the other hoop. You see who he's playing against, who's in the lineup right now, who's playing. It's just a beautiful, beautiful shot, And same with this, against the Pacers, away against the Pacers, It's awesome, Nice little holographic of it, Wait a minute, that's not even Eddie, right? I'm seeing that, right? 40? That's a 4, right? Oh, 4 and a Sonics on the side. All right, so there's Eddie there. What is that? 40. That's a Pacer. All right, no, it's not. That's a Sonic. Is that Kemp? Why is, hold up, let me read the back. Showtime, so it's him on the back there. All-Star Weekend. It's like, yo, someone in the comments, I'll have to look that up. Someone in the comments, it looks like Sean Kemp. It looks like a Seattle Supersonics. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do some research on that, but all right, I've already taken up enough time, but that is interesting. That is very interesting. Eddie Jones, yeah. All right, so I'm gonna have to go do some research. You guys have a wonderful evening. Oh, last thing, yeah, you guys wanted to see the yeah, my favorite hockey player of all time, Brendan Shanahan. Still complete in box, really, really good shape. Yeah, so I still collect certain starting lineups, like Eddie Jones, Mattingly, Brendan Shanahan, of course, Montana and Rice. Some of my all-time faves. I like finding these. Loose, even. I even still collect them loose. I don't mind finding them loose. Eric Lindros. I don't mind. So, yeah. Very cool. Starting lineups back in the day were awesome. They still are awesome. Yeah, I'd love to have the room to set a few of mine all out. But, all right, yeah, we're 20 plus minutes into this. Let me go ahead and end it. Thanks for sitting through the whole thing. And I'm going to go do some research. You all have a good night.